Our Letter Star Series Season 14, our final match here for the online portion of it, is going to be getting started right now. It's XTSM taking on Team Envious. My name is Blue. Joining me here is Metas. So let's get right into our first map here, which is going to be Inferno. Metas, what do you think of this one?
It's a really difficult game to call. I honestly feel Blue. I think both teams, obviously top tier teams, some of the best teams in the entire world. I'd probably slightly edge with Envious, although I think these maps definitely do favor XTSM to an extent. For example, Train second map, I think they should definitely be taking. So I think we are going to see all three maps today. How about yourself?
I believe we'll see all three maps too. Both these teams, their recent performances back at the SLESA Pro League seem like pretty close contenders. Still having some weaknesses on either ends, but it still kind of puts them at that same sort of level here. So very, very close map coming up between these two. And the pistol run action already getting started here. Cajun Beat holding that balcony area at first, but he's going to get overwhelmed with some degree. Actually, correcting myself, did a free to extend a second player before Kenny S is finally able to drop one of these guys. Now it leaves it down to a 3v2. Envious, having all the problems getting into the site that they do, it's left down to Happy and Kenny now to try and hold things off. They do manage to clear things out in the pit and get partial site control, but the retake is so, so close to these players right now, and they're already wrapping around Porch. It's going to be Zipex along with Kerrigan trying to find their way in. They do get a lock onto Kenny sitting back over there inside a pit, so they get some great damage over onto him, and now Kerrigan working his way in. They overwhelm Happy, and now it's just Kenny there. They're going to have to try and take him down using that smoke to try and get some momentum, but it's not working out. However, they're not going for that defuse as of yet, but Kerrigan will be eventually taking him down, and that first pistol round is going to go by the way of XTSM.
It is pretty decent retake overall, but of course with that bomb being planted, now there are some options for Envious. Do they want to save up and get the AKs in round three, or do they want to go for the force up? Now Envious, of course, are known for going for a lot of forces, have incredible individual talent and a lot of awesome aim on their side, but I think this is the correct decision. They're going to be tapping up for this round, just a couple of upgraded pistols, and then playing for round number three, which is when we're going to see the executes come to fruition. Look at this from question mark, though. 4 assault rifles and 1 P90, so they're not taking this round lightly whatsoever. They're playing it to win.
Yeah, the P90 they have too is not really going to give them a big economy boost, so these guys are just playing it basically for the victory here, assuming Envious was going to go for the force up on the second round, which is not going to be happening here. We're just seeing them take their time nice and slowly here at the beginning of this round, trying to figure out if they can find an early player, but for the most part, XTSM is playing this pretty passively too, just hanging back, waiting for Envious to play it into them, and we'll see that action start in a second here. It actually looks like they may start the B push a little bit earlier, at least try to find a way into it, but they're already getting fought back from Kerrigan down over there at Spools, so probably not going to be happening, and those players just fall right back, and they're going to regroup back over here by the crossroads in the middle.
Apparently my microphone's like really bad, so I'm gonna try and fix this, Blue.
It sounds fine to me. You might be getting trolled.
Possibly. That's true. It could definitely be a troll. Here comes the heavy Kato, and he is pushing up the archer's side, but as expected, those assault rifles with Hamas holding on strong. Cajun B with 3, and suddenly it's all unhappy. He was in the apps, and he gets picked off as well from Dupree this time around. So, question mark holding on to 4 weapons, and now Envious will have their AK-47s.
It looks like you're getting trolled.
Great banter. It really is.
Great banter. Top kicks. All right, so XTSM get themselves over a bit of a hump here, but now we're going to get into the tough round for them, which is Envious investing into the AKs on round number 3 because they do get that plant back on the first round. So we'll see AKs, not a whole lot of utility when it comes to like mollies or HEs, but they do have enough smokes and whatnot to make a take. It just depends on the speed they go about it here. That's really going to choose whether they really needed those mollies or HEs. So far, it doesn't really seem like they're too worthy, and again, CSM trying to toss some of their own nades back over here towards alt and main middle, but not connecting really onto anything. It'll actually be NBK that picks up the first blow here. They're going to catch Device through the mid choke point. This should open them up for a push to at least get control of this area of the map.
One casualty so far, but again, Envious come out swinging, 2 frags in quick succession. Leave Zipnix and Kerrigan all that remains. They're both the B players. And honestly, judging from their positions right now, I just don't feel they're going to go for this one. They're going to just try and save onto these weapons. And that will be Envious bouncing back and potentially keeping all their weapons alive here.
Yeah, everybody, Envious already getting full control, just trying to investigate where the final couple bits of resistance are from the CT side. And in just a moment here, Keo's probably going to find them if he continues to press up Banana. Zipix is going to try to hold that angle off against him, but not finding it as of yet. And now they're on the hunt, moving out to try and catch these final players, prevent that save. They've already got the round in the bag here. Now it's about closing it out here, and Kerrigan gonna completely miss the connection on his first shots too, so he's been revealed, but thankfully Zipex is doing a great job of trying to hold it up. Keo shuts him down though, and now it's just Kerrigan. They just have to hunt him down, and a 5-on-1, they will be going for him, so In comes the cavalry now from the side of Envious. He's trapped, and at Happy picking up a great nice headshot there to shut him out. And there's going to be no saves at all for XTSM heading into that next round.
Oh man, that's a double whammy as well. Not only are there no weapons safe for question mark, but additionally, full weapons safe for Envious. So that's going to make their bank balance boom. You can now see that question mark have a decision to make. Do they want to go for the force here, try and bounce back? It's probably not the correct decision. And they're going to decide against that. Just the CZ, PT-50. And this should be Envious again. Let's see how question mark XTSM are going to progress into this round, though. Are they going to go for any cheeky stacks? Are they going to go for any cheeky aggression plays? Doesn't look like it. Just standard setup for now.
And now moving themselves up towards the choke point here. NBK going to look to maybe find Dupree, but he's playing it out over here inside a boiler right now. Looking for a close resistance to the push from Envious, as they have gone for some aggressive apartments control here on the CT side. Not going to be finding it just as of yet, but also there's really nobody to stop any sort of push coming to that mid choke point, so he could very easily just get wrapped in there from the boiler and get taken down. Already going to get shot, trying to move himself back towards it, but there's Cage and B actually picking up a first blow this time. It's going to be Dupree that tries to roll back up. He's shut down very quickly by Apex, and the rest of these guys now just going to press right forward onto that A site. They've already got pretty much a good amount of control of it. You've just got Cajun and Device trying to hold the rest of this one off and looking for the nice headshot angle. Cajun specifically is going to meet most of this combat here, but again, he's forced back, and for the most part, actually, Envious are a little bit scared of that, so they go back down middle, and I think they're going to switch this to a B approach just to keep it safe.
Yeah, well, judging off what we can see, obviously, that is the correct decision. There's only the one player there, it's Carrigan. I said that, but he got PT-50, and we know that he's very capable of pulling off crazy plays. Meanwhile, it's MBK that's moving his way onto the A side, trying to fake this one out right now, keep the CTs interested. And XTSM seems to be biting on this, keeping three players there. Finally, Zipnex is starting to make his way across to the B side. And still, this aggression hasn't quite came out from Team Envious. I'm a bit worried for them, but there's the frags landing down. And finally, they will be executing onto this site, and indeed the players that they find as well. So 2-2, Envious only losing Happy in the process. But here comes another buy from XTSM.
And again, it's going to be a little bit more forced up this time on a couple of players just because of the lower amounts of cash they have to invest on a full M4. Dupree is actually just going to take the route of going for the Mag 7 this time. And if he plays it like he did in the last round, just going to be sticking around the boiler area looking for close-up battles either by mid-choke or over towards the T-steps to knock out a couple guys. But unfortunately, Envious, at least in these past like two rounds now, haven't really been investigating things in the apartment so much. They've basically just been taking a straightforward approach, going either through the mid-choke or just going directly up Banana. So I'm not exactly sure how potent this Mag 7 is going to be, especially when you look at the path Envious is taking right now, and they're just going right forward here too. They catch Kerrigan off guard, but thankfully Zipex is here. He's able to respond, but then in comes Keo. He's able to find Kerrigan out in the open as they move forward here. They're going to press Zipex back inside of construction. He won't be able to resist anything else for the time being, but the rotations are coming in fast for XTSM, so they're going to have a lot of opportunities to get back into this site. KJB starts it off, takes down Apex. The rest of these guys trying to hold it back off now, but not moving a whole lot of pressure back in just as of yet, and Happy having a great position here too. He picks up one, looking for KJB, but then Kenny's going to come in on the assist through the smoke. He takes him back down. The final two, not a whole lot left to do. They are going to try to chase down Happy, and Zipix might be able to pull that one off. He does, in fact, do so, but now they're stuck outside of this one. Retake Dream is pretty much dead here, and they have to fall back and save the rifles once again.
Absolutely dead and buried. Happy, as you call, was in such a good position there, just on the tight angle, waiting for the CTs to push his location. He locks it down. There's a brilliant crossfire from Envious, and they are going to take round number 5 and put it in their back pocket. Sadly enough as well for XTSM, they're unable to save that second weapon, so it's really only Dupree that has anything going forward into this round. And after a blistering start from XTSM I should say, they suddenly are looking down the barrel of a gun. Envy assured on paper take this 4-2 lead, and it's a lot of pressure mounting now for XTSM.
So Envious again with good amount of pressure being applied there, just on a forced strategy. We can see they'll take it slower again because XTSM are going to be back down. No Nico this time. XTSM is also going to try to play this aggressively too. They're actually taking a big risk sending their only rifle this far up, but it pays off. Dupree's able to pick up a nice first kill here by shutting down Apex. It does lead itself into just being an even trade, which doesn't necessarily benefit XTSM all that much. At the very least, it holds back some of the aggression and keeps the map control in their favor for a little bit longer of a period of time here, as Envious is going to have to try to find a safer route into the site after losing one of their players.
Yeah, I like the idea there. Dupree had a pretty decent spawn that pushed the apps area, and he did just that. Now he's rotating himself towards that B side in case the rotation comes in from Envious, but it's going to be the A play. The bomb is there as well. There's no... We're going to try and run interference right here. Happy's going to go off first on the site. That's going to leave Cajun B and a CZ. All that remains over on the A side for XTSM. He's been spotted and fragged. That will be a bomb plant. And judging from those positions, Dupree just wants to save his AK-47. So this will be a pretty clear-cut round in the end for Envious once again, as expected.
Yeah, the final two here from XTSM just going to be completely out of position. And as well, they still have that rifle in their hands on Dupree, so it's going to be much better to save that. I'll just try and save some cash, as obviously the CT side, very, very volatile to keep your buys up and as potent as you would like, so they're going to want to try and keep that in their arsenal. So as to when they go for the buy in the next round here, it's going to save them quite a bit of cash compared to spending 3,100 or however much on the rifle there. Zipix, he won't be getting much, saves a P250, but it's not really anything super crazy, so wouldn't actually be surprised if he tried to force his way out and look for a frag or two, but Kyo's waiting just on the other side of that corner, so if he does do this, then he's probably a dead man.
The pretty crazy stat as well, by the way, that I've just been looking at before. They're coming into this since TSM obviously left their org and turned into XTSM. They've played Inferno 3 times and they've won every single pistol round. So up until today, they were 6-6. And of course, I believe they took this one as well. So they're 7-7 in pistol rounds, which is a pretty crazy stat. This goes to show how dominant XTSM are with those pistols. That being said, even though they did get the pistol round, since then it's been one-way traffic in Team Envious's hands. But here we go. Another buy-up, this time with the AWP in play for Device. Let's see if he can make it work. He's taken that over onto the short side of A, which is where the majority of these executes have been coming in from Envious.
Device is going to miss the connection on his first op shot there. Screws up the timing. They start to work their way back out. Device is going to save his teammate's life on balcony, but misses another close-up shot there. Now we can see these guys moving in very quickly, but Dupree and Cajun B still doing a good job of holding things off, both from the site approach along with in pit, and they just completely shut down the approach. They recover the op as well. Great hold from XTSM to pick up a third round.
Yeah, explosive action, holding on firm, and very nicely held indeed, and that's going to give them now a bit of confidence boost after Envious were looking so potent with their aggression. Kenny S now is going to pick himself up the AWP. Doesn't have the greatest spawn to be peeking up Banana, for example, but going to be playing this one slow and steady. Device, meanwhile, now moving over towards the B side. Three-man stack from XTSM on the B side of the map. And there we go, it's the ladder first one, but he gets traded out straight away from Kenny S. One-for-one trade will favor Envious in this confrontation, though.
Yeah, so Envious are going to pick up the trade there. We do see the Opera still being left alive here from the side of Team Envious, so Kenny's still going to be up and going here as these guys try to press their way in. But Zipix, one of the tight corner just inside of the porch here, as these guys push their way closer and closer to it, and the members of XTSM have to split themselves up evenly too, but there's Zipix lining up a perfect shot. Takes down Kenny, that flash should connect too, but he's got to be careful about it. They're throwing the smoke in there for the time being, and the blind spray coming back in. They actually get some damage on his Zipix, and he's going to get taken down through the porch by NBK. That's another trade that comes out, but it still heavily favors XTSM now, as they're left with a 3-on-2 advantage here, and the two members of Envious have made very little map progression here to take control. Happy, though, as I correct myself here, has moved all the way through over here towards Arches now. He's actually just sitting just outside a library, and KJB has no clue that he's pushed this far forward. So that could be an easy frag if he goes about this slowly enough. And MBK, he's going to be the first one out there. He doesn't actually even spot KJB, but Cage is burning alive, so he's got to be careful. He's got to run back out, but Happy doesn't take the chance to actually take him down successfully. So he rolls back out, he jumps, and Dupree's going to get an easy kill because of that, so they tie it back up.
I can only assume that Happy was startled there when he jumped up into the air. I'm sure that was a panic jump. Because, of course, it's not going to help his accuracy whatsoever, and he ends up getting wrecked as a result. Envious, though, easy rebuy-in for them, including a Tech-9 on Apex, but we know what the Tech-9 is capable of. And an important hold as well for XTSM. KJB's position is very interesting. He's done that a couple of times. The idea is that you get a huge field of view, so you can see both the long and also the short side, plus the apps on the A. So you get a lot of information. You can drop back, but we almost saw him get killed by the Molotov. It was very awkward for a couple of seconds. That being said, first frag comes down. It's going to be Dupree in mid. And again, this banana control from XTSM pushing right down there, getting a lot of information in the process.
Device picking up a second frag though with that op, doing some serious work with it right now, back over towards Banana, not giving Envious really anything to work towards. NBK trying to look for a response to it, but he's going to mess up his flash, so obviously nothing really going to be gained by pushing towards that angle. Happy has made some progress getting himself inside of Boiler, though, but looking for a response. All he's going to do is give away his position and cause some noise, but the rest of Envious now pressing their way back up Banana. They're not going to take the bomb with them just as of yet. Happy is going to be relocating with them as soon as they actually find their way in towards that B site, and they only have actually one player here to hold it right now. There's going to be more coming back in a moment because of these shots fired off here by Team Envious, but they've still got smokes and whatnot to hold this off, but again, remember with the timers and whatnot now being changed, it's not going to be as punishing to them. They can wait it out a little bit longer.
Absolutely. Now Zipnex has got into position, so whereas before it was just Carrigan, now the cavalry has arrived. 30 seconds left on the timer, and Envious pretty much have to go for broke right here, right now. I'm going to start to push through the smoke. Apex down for 41, has the AK-47. Now he gets sprayed out from Carrigan. He's looking for a second, he picks it up, and has a chance to actually go and reload as well. This could be a clean sweep. for XTSM. Indeed it will be, and they keep stomping forward. I've got to say, though, if Envious can just keep themselves neck and neck, they'll be pretty happy with this T side, but RXTSM about to just pull away.
Yeah, that's just a complete shutdown there from XTSM now, so it's finally going to force the reset here for the guys on Envious. Just going to be Deagles being invested for the most part in this round. A couple P250s and the Tech9 armor on NBK, but beyond that, nothing really notable to be brought into this one. It's probably just going to be a direct play onto one of the sites, not expecting anything super strategical. And in fact, it looks like most players are just going for a big push-up banana right now, but the double stack nade comes in from ZipX along with Kerrigan. They shut down Apex. They get some good damage on NBK too, so that's immediately probably going to kill the quick take as these guys are now held back. And they're actually going to try to fend off some aggression. NBK inside the pit, locks onto that headshot there, shuts down Dupree. So they at least find a trade with no pickups being found. You can't really call this a good situation for Envious as of yet.
Not really, especially as Cajun B's gone in as well and landed himself the headshot. There are still three Deagles in play, though. And we all know and fear what the Deagle is capable of doing in these kind of rounds, especially in the hands of Envious, who are renowned for picking up the Deagles. Happy, for example, pulled off one of the craziest plays here on Inferno. With just that weapon. Device goes for the peak. Yashima can't get it locked down, and he will end up falling as a result. Last two players are going to the top of Kadana, and now XTSM are starting to filter out of A to get some information. So I feel Envious not long for this world. XTSM should be picking this one up pretty easily. Yep. A lot of issues with GoTV just randomly watching corpses, by the way. Are you having it as well?
Yep, I think people in the other language casters are complaining about it too.
It's so weird.
Our GoTV is just like drunk right now.
It's like action going on. It's like, yeah, but watch the corpse, though.
Look at this that corpse, ass. Man.
Brilliant. Thanks a lot, crazy. Bro.
The good news is with this new update, like, chat can't blame us for it anymore because, like, they know when we're on auto-director. Did you notice that yet? If you turn auto-director on, there's, like, that thing that pops up in the nameplate or whatever you call that. I didn't notice that because I, like, didn't even get to play the patch until I got home on Monday.
GoTV is indeed drunk. Yes.
So, to start this round off, Envious pressing their way up banana. Actually, XTSM took a risk this time because they four stack on the A site, assuming it's just going to roll in there. If Envious go forward with this push, now ZipX is doing a great job of applying some aggressive nades to keep it back, and he had the team smoke coming in from the other side of the map too, so he still has his own smoke to try and hold this back, and the flashbangs and whatnot that he's throwing out now are actually going to do a fantastic job, but he's caught with a nade out now as the rush actually comes in. He needs that rotation quickly enough. He's way out in the open, so that's going to be an easy opening frag going by the way of Envious now as they press their way towards it. Kerrigan, is he actually going to go for this with no reinforcements? He's pressing through that smoke, picks up a first one, trying to find a second on NBK, but it's not going to happen. Apex shuts him out, and the rest of XTSM, again, the save call has to come in.
Absolutely does. There's no point trying to throw away these weapons, even though they have been consistently getting the saves and getting a lot of super competent rounds their way. They got 11k still on device. It's just not worth going in on this one. Even though Envious are pretty low, there's no way of XTSM knowing this for absolute certainty. So looking for the exit frags and see if that bomb can detonate a couple players as well. And now starting to filter their way down Banana. It's going to be into the embracing arms of Cajun B, who picks up the one and will back on off. The bomb doesn't take anyone down with it. And therefore, Envious should be able to keep three weapons alive. Decent round for them, but XTSM will be bouncing right back.
Yeah, XTSM still have plenty of cash, so no problem at all for them going for the revives. The big thing is just going to be... I actually really don't know why we saw them changing up to like a four-man stack on the A side all of a sudden, because Envious have been keeping their strategies on this T side pretty varied for the most part. It's not like they were just going hard on the A side for like five or six rounds and then suddenly switched up to B. They've been pressuring both. It was a bit of like a random decision to just try and go for a four stack on A. And a big, big vote of faith towards ZipX too, but that just doesn't pay off as ZipX gets caught with his pants down essentially. And then the rotate there is just going to be way too slow regardless. So Envious are given a pretty easy round because of that poor choice of placement there from the members of XTSM.
Yeah, the very top level, that one small mistake can cost so big. It really is a game of milliseconds or millimeters. And for those of you asking, this is Envious's choice of map. They have conceded the first death and the second as well. Device on short is going to make quick work of both Happy and also Apex. It's still in position. So right off the get-go, Envious at a huge disadvantage. Surprised they're both peeking, though, in all honesty. As soon as that first kill comes down, maybe throw the flash out. And just back on off. That being said, the bomb is still occupying mid. It can easily wrap itself around to B if they can get that pick. But so far, so good for XTSM once again. It's just got a whole lot better as MBK gets shut down.
Yeah, even if he presses back in there, you still have Dupree hugging the Jesus Pulk. He was going to find a nice entry back over there on Rap side, but there's Dupree just waiting for him. Easily shuts him down. Kenny's going to get mollied off. He can't push his way in. 30 seconds left. He might try to rotate towards B, but he is trapped to a certain degree. So there's not really going to be a whole lot that he can do to try and swing this back in his favor. Ooh, gets that one entry at the least, but Kerrigan's quick on the draw to find a trade. And they do strike right back to pick up a seventh round.
Now Envious are in a position where their economy is not too fantastic, so they're going to force this one up. That is super interesting, including an MP7. They must know that XTSM's economy is just booming right now. There's no easy frags. There's no one with a lack of head armor, for example. So this is what we were talking about before when we said that Envious are known for force buying in situations where most teams would tap out. My goodness. But it could work for them, as they've got that AK-47 on Happy. They've still got some decent weapons across the board. And it looks like they're going to stack down, but look at this from XTSM. They push down Banana. They know that Envious have to be mid or second mid, and therefore they could even wrap themselves around this Kerrigan that goes in first, but he gets fragged himself. And that is a big pick. It's only one of the only ways I feel that Envious win this round is by XTSM getting too aggressive.
And they're going to press their way out again, sit down. Not checking that wrap side quickly enough. There's a great spray control there from ZipX as he picks up two. Device finding another one back on Banana. They try to press the bomb there, but NBK following suit. He picks up a response, and he's got a rifle in his hands now. Dupree still able to pick up some frags back over there by the porch, but Happy quick enough on the trade for it. NBK has found his way inside of CT spawn, but he is being followed to a certain degree by Cajun B. He's going to find him in a second, lining up that shot, but missing the connection. So NBK gets alerted to this and tries to turn it back around. In the meantime, Device still picking up those shots with the op on Banana. It's now just on NBK to clutch up the 1v2. He's going to chase Device to the punch over here, but he's over peeking. I don't think he realizes he's sitting in the corner. No, he does not. So Device is just going to completely outmaneuver him, shuts him down, and there's XTSM picking up yet another round for themselves here, getting a much more solid lead here on that CT side now up to 8 rounds.
Yeah, and we're seeing how much that force buy hurts Envious now. Effectively a 2-for-1 round as they're going to go for some more upgraded pistols, but all around the 3-to-2K mark. So it really does hurt them quite significantly. If they go for that eco, they can get a decent buy up here instead, but obviously seeing a window of opportunity, but it was closed very comfortably in the end from XTSM and Device in particular. Speaking of the man Device, again, he has the AWP, and again, he is going to be playing this one in mid. Like, pretty aggressive plays, must realize that there is a lack of economy on the side of Envious. They don't go for the aggression on the B side this time through Banana, instead playing more passive. There's the first frag from Cajun B. Dupree's going to lock down on the other side of the map. And this is looking good for XTSM once again.
Yeah, the aggressive push towards A just completely fails. They got this B push held off pretty nicely too. Molly followed up by Smoke, and he's going to try to press through that, but Zipix is handling himself quite well right now. Apex actually bursts through it and picks up one, but again, the trades from XTSM are very, very consistent right now. Even when they do lose players, they're consistently able to pick up the response kill fast enough, and that, in these previous couple of rounds, has been throwing so many in their direction. Envious were keeping it very competitive up to a certain point, but have now fallen by the wayside. Don't get me wrong, 5 rounds on T-side in Inferno is still very, very good, but with the way that they were forging this forward previously, we would hope they would be at the very least be able to try and find a 6th here. Actually,
absolutely.
look at what Device and Cajun are doing right now. Look, they're
juggling,
like,
the weapons.
Yeah, they're juggling the weapons up over here to the corner so that I think someone has like an extra rifle or an op or something with them.
Yeah, with it being the last round, allows you to go for the quick peeks. It may not even matter though. Hold the phone, is XTSM playing aggressive down Banana again. And look where that bomb has been dropped, in a bottleneck. Pretty much the worst possible position as far as Envious are concerned. And although Carrigan's pretty low, only MBK and Happy remain, and they're both low themselves. They're trying what they can, but there's Device with the AWP headshot, overkill, and there's the final frag to clear things up. 10-5. As you say though, Blue, 5 rounds is definitely doable, especially considering Envious' CT side on Inferno is pretty crazy strong. But I feel I'd be very disappointed, because it was, what, 5-5 at one point? So they would have been hoping for like 6-7, potentially even 8 rounds here.
I think the big thing, again, a 10-5 lead is still very dominant for the members of XTSM, so if they are able to pick up the starting lead here by following it with the pistol and then getting that second round too, if Envious choose the force, which more than likely they will, then that's going to become a problem, because Envious, regardless of the advantages that come with CT side, they still have to work against up to like 8 rounds to get back into a tight situation and then take a lead from there. So despite Envious doing a good job, and again, 5 rounds on T side is not bad at all, they need to now shut things down here at the beginning of the second half. Otherwise, XTSM is still going to have a very, very comfortable lead, and Device starts it off strong again, shutting down Kenny. And now they've already got Banana control. There's only one player from the B side. One's going to rotate. They'll split it 2-2, but that's not really too good of a story either, unfortunately, for Envious's defense.
Absolutely not, especially in pistol rounds, so we can just chime together and just rush in. And I said before, up until this point, as XTSM, they picked up 7 out of 7 pistol rounds on Inferno so far, just over the last week or so. And it looks like it could very well be 8 out of 8, as the remaining player on B has been picked off. That's Kiyoshima. That leaves MBK trying to retake this site by himself. Misses the first couple of taps. That could be at the cost of his life. Bomb has been planted. That's the headshot. And now Happy comes on in. and really little to no hope in effect. So XTSM will be taking the 11-5 lead. This is a pistol round Envious desperately required.
And now that's just a sad story here, because XT, or Envious, I should say, if they don't go for the investment now, like I was saying before, that's going to give them an extremely comfortable lead as they get shut down on that pistol round, and XTSM wasting no time at all going for their own investments here in the second round. They do go for the more normal buy of going for the two AKs and then picking up the three SMGs right after that, so it'll be Cajun, Kerrigan, and Dupree looking to try and stack up some cash at the beginning of the round, but as we expected here too, with the exception of Kenny, who needs to save up for the op, everybody's going to invest in the upgraded pistol with armor sitting behind it, but this play is probably going to come in so quickly, Envious may not even have time to react to this now. They are ready to toss out flashbangs and whatnot, but thankfully they're held back a little bit at the car angle by Amali. I think that gets tossed out by the CTs.
A real rough hold here for Envious, but they are kings with a pistol in these kind of situations. These forces, the first frag goes their way, it's happy. And if he just peeks out there and gets a bit of courage, he could very well get that weapon for himself as well. So a decent start, the dink on Kerrigan from Apex, who will be eradicated courtesy of Cajun B's MAC-10. But there is damage being inflicted. The AK's been picked up on Happy, who has the Kevlar as well. Here comes the retake. Potentially Happy's all that remains, though. But there's three players who are so low blue, they just one shot away from death. If he could pick up this frag in library, it was doable. But he gets shut down from Dupree. Close range, MAC-10 sprayage. 12-5 now, the scoreline, and Envious pretty much have to just tap out of this round as well.
They were so close to having that pinch there, but actually, outside a pit around the truck area. You could see that too. They had that nastily lined up. I think it was Kiyoshima that was sitting inside a pit that kept themselves a secret until like four players were stacked up and they almost just wrecked them. But all three somehow managed to make it out of that. And in fact, like the total combined HP of like all four of those players at the end of that one had to be around like just 60 at most. So
yeah,
those guys were so close to dying, and that could have been around for Envious, but it doesn't happen. And this may just end up costing them the map now, because we're going to be looking at a very, very comfortable lead here for XTSM. This is the garbage round for Envious now. So if they take this one, it'll be an absolute miracle. But 99% of the time, XTSM are just going to run this round.
Absolutely. It would be more of a mistake, I'd say, from XTSM than a huge play from Envious necessarily, because if you use your utility to its utmost effect, it's easy pickings. But Happy does pick up the first frag, just hiding on the outskirts of the smoke. Gets the drop, but then gets traded out instantly. The bomb still hasn't moved towards the B side. It's starting to get banana right now in the hands of Dupree. Kerrigan with the spray down for the MP7, looking for the second. Connected as well. And that is lights out for Envious in this round. Surely Kerrigan even gets a cheeky third frag, leaving Kiyoshima on 2 HP. He gets picked off 13-5. And keep in mind as well, Blue, the next map is Train. And that's a map that I feel XTSM will be heavy favorites on. So if Envious concede this map, things could go very, very dodgy indeed for them.
They beat Na'Vi on it just as the land last week, so
yep.
Definitely going to be a rough one if they do manage to forge through and pick this one up. And for Envious now, they'll get their investment, but it's going to be such a Hail Mary now at this point. They need to pick up this round and keep it consistent from this point forward, as XTSM have a huge cushion to work with here. So we can see the most of XTSM, and they're playing a much more direct T side too. They're not really giving the guys over here on Envious really any room to breathe at all. They're just going directly at it. And as they press their way forward, Cajun takes that charge. They do throw a Molly, and of course, that got some damage on the Happy. He's going to fall back a little bit closer to the CT. He's not going to push them out of it just as of yet. You can notice here, too, that for a minute here, Cajun B did have a little bit of an angle to work for. That was actually going to be pretty specific to the Happy when he crossed, but I think that's been smoked off now. So he may not be able to see it. He might be able to catch his foot, but I don't think he's going to be able to connect the kill. He gets him in that area there. So most of XTSM is just held back for the time being, but Happy, he's getting a little bit aggressive now. He's going to try to push up against these players as he takes up that jump spotted position. And the smoke comes in for a third time now. These guys are smoking it off. In come these players. Happy holding one off. NBK found a kill here too, but now he's going to get dropped. Back over here on the A site. Zipix picking up one. Kerrigan also finding some frags. They get control of that B site and the bomb goes down, but the rotations are coming in quick. And they're still missing one player from this B site right now.
They are. And really, this is almost last chance loot for Envious. Be playing for overtime if they potentially lose this one. So here we go. They're going right in. Kiyoshima lands the first frag in this confrontation. 2-on-2. No defuse kit though for Envious. They do have a bit of utility. Kenny S is stood in the Molotov. He's going to end up burning out. So unfortunate. Now Kiyoshima goes in by himself. He's looking for the frags. Finally finds Kerrigan. Is there time though? There really isn't. He has to pretty much stick it from here on out. He's going to try and draw out Zip next to get the frag. He falls down. And now there is a massive cushion, a massive buffer for rounds of XTSM. And just to add to the wearies already of Envious. Look at that economy, Blue.
Yep.
Ripping pepperonis.
It's in the dump. For the most part here. We'll see him force, obviously, because it's going to be 14th round now for XTSM, but it doesn't really leave them with anything to work with. In fact, Happy can't even get the full buy. He just has to go down to a CZ. not even everybody can afford a smoke at this point. So they can hold things off, they can bring that timer down once again, but at the end of the day, 9 times out of 10 here, XCSM is still going to be able to force right through this. And they'll still be able to make an aggressive enough push to get in to that B or A site. And for the most part here in this half, it's basically just been B pushes and looking like it's going to follow suit with that once again here in this one.
Yeah, just almost bullying, honestly, Envious on the B side, just going for the shock and awe kind of tactic. And the round here, they must know as soon as they find out there's a couple of FAMASes, there's going to be a distinct lack of utility on the board. And therefore, if they just play the time, eventually those smokes, those HEs will be utilized. Or they could just get entry frags. That's another way of approaching this, I guess. Zipmex is going to go in. And Envious feeling like they're pressured to find the information. Both walk into a trap. And will find themselves put 6 foot under. Here's Kiyoshima, though, trying to hold down. Quad, he falls out. Happy's been tagged. He will be fragged as well. And now it's on MBK. This looks like it will be a 10-round lead. XTSM. I thought this match would be close. It's been anything but so far.
Yeah, Envious obviously have a lot of work to do. This CT side, like we were saying before, the unfortunate thing that happens is XTSM, they pick up the pistol in second half with already having a 10-5 lead. So, to be honest, Envious never really get a chance to show off their CT side, but that T side as well starts off great, but the problem is they often rely on just on every map, like a chaotic T side, in order to pick up rounds, and XTSM were able to get the read onto them and then just shut things down in like this the last third of the half there. So unfortunately, that gives the members of XTSM a very, very strong lead, and at the end of the day there, it just goes too much in your favor of XTSM for Envious to make a comeback on here on the CT side.
At this point, honestly, Envious may be just dusting themselves down and thinking about train. You know, a 10-round deficit, we've seen crazy things happen in Counter-Strike, but this would be a ridiculous comeback, judging from their economy, judging the fact they're playing against XTSM as well. Full AK-47s, haven't bothered with any AWP upgrades. They really haven't needed to. Their executions, their up-close and personal confrontations have all gone their way, so why change it? And that being said, Envious now, maybe going to try and play a little bit more aggressive in Banana Happy with one of those FAMASes. He's holding the close angle. The flash comes through. He's pushing out the next Agent B. As soon as that flash landed, they knew the push was imminent, and they just hold down the trigger. So 4v5, looking like it's going to go the same way again, this time to XTSM.
Envious are biting hard on a rotation too. They actually almost fully rotated off the A site. They're going to try to reposition players now, but Apex is caught out to a certain degree. We're still seeing Kyo trying to fall back to get into his regular position back over here around the pit. He has to fall back to site because he actually can't hold things very well, but still managing to pick up some frags there. He's able to shut down Kerrigan, now moving forward. Good angle held by Apex there, finding a second pickup, and then Apex actually finds another one through the box, shuts out Cajun. Zipix, and Zipix again finding two responses to it, so it's even back out to a 2v2, but goddamn auto-director. MBK takes down Zipix right after that one. It's left out to a 1v1. Can he picking up the AK there? So he's definitely going to be able to do this, but Device, he's going to try to chase him down. I don't think Device realized just how close Kenny is. It might be a shot to the back here in a second. It's going to be a shot to the face, but close enough there. Kenny S shuts it down and keeps Envious in this game for just a little bit longer.
Problem is, though, Blue, with their economy, again, it's not going to be a fantastic buy-up. They only kept one weapon in place, a couple of FAMASes, XM, a CZ as well. And as you can see, XTSM able to rummage together 4 assault rifles with a healthy dose of grenades as well. So, yes, Envious, you've navigated your way over that first obstacle, but there's so many more coming up. They're not out of the woods just yet. 3 assault rifles. The XM at close range is devastatingly powerful, but we've already seen that XTSM are okay with just charging onto those sites. The early trade comes out. Apex and Zipnex both bag themselves a frag. And again, Envious now have to spread that little bit more thin. The XM is going to be used in apps. This is probably the best place for it, other than maybe close on B. But Kyo's not getting any information just yet.
So held back now, or specifically pushed forward, Kiyoshima inside the apartment. He's going to get challenged in a second, but good response from Zipex. Shuts down Kyo on the way out here, and is immediately going to press forward. The rest of his team coming through that mid choke point too. They're going to be relying completely on Kenny to hold this one back off. He picks up a first frag, looking for more. He still thinks there's pressure that's going to be coming out from the balcony over there, but this is not the case. He's one of the only players here to defend it. Happy arrives. Kenny still picking up these frags. Nobody tries to wrap him. Him and Happy do a great job of holding that one up, and Kenny just shutting things down. He picks up a 3K on this round, and almost single-handedly defends the A site.
Very nicely done again, and this could be a bit of a respite now for Envious. Again, they lost 3 players, but this should potentially be an XTSM save. Just with some upgraded pistols, and that's all. So this is Envious' chance now to rummage together and get themselves a healthier buy-up next round. They've got an open play from Kenny S, who didn't have the greatest spawn to quick peek mid, but if they assume this is pistols, he may not want to peek mid anyway. That's kind of walking into potential trap. XTSM looking to push up mid and Banana, respectively. That bomb is still in transition in mid itself. Happy catches the first player. Easy pickings for him. And XTSM may just try and retaliate with raw aggression right now, because in the 3v5, pistols against rifles by and large, there's really no hope. You have to go for something crazy, and going slow through mid, just walking to Apex's crosshairs, you'll take them all day.
Yep, it's just going to be Device left as the final player now. He'll try to push his way up towards Banana, but as you mentioned here, they've already got bomb control from Envious, so they just have to wait that one out. He may be able to sneak his way through and find something on NBK, but more than likely, as soon as he peeks around that corner there, and NBK just spotted him, so just shutting him down at this point. They've got his location, and he's just going to take the duel. There's no use waiting that one out. Nothing you can do about that one. He'll just take the death, and then he'll throw the round over towards Envious now as they try to stack up their money a little bit more, get that utility stronger. Keo still actually sticking with the auto shotty for now. So he's going to be playing that either inside apartments on B. He's been playing in apartments, so I imagine that would continue. But considering that XT Sim are aware of this, more likely they can just sort of avoid that and use other angles of the map.
Yeah, exactly. It's one of those kind of weapons, the XM. I think it's an underrated weapon. You do see a couple of players. I remember GetRight using it for a little while as well. You see players using it in Drop Zone, for example, on Cobblestone. It can be ridiculously powerful. But as you say, if you know someone's got that shotgun, you can actually play around it. Shotguns are not great at retaking sites, for example. Obviously, at mid to long range, it's absolutely useless. So, XTSM going for this super aggression play again, but Apex gets the drop onto Dupree. He not checked behind the little pillar there. Molotov's been thrown out. Zipnex now has to back away or run through the flames and fire. But Carrigan comes through from the other side, bags himself a frag. Meanwhile, two players are going to be coming through Library. That's Happy and Kenny S. And their teammate of MBK through Arches. So it's going to have to be the retake right now. And I think he just got aided by his own teammate. So unfortunate. It bounces off the wall. Does significant damage. MBK on the other side. The two headshots. Beautiful play from him. That leaves Carrigan in a 1v3. And he's being encircled right now. Players left, right, and center. There's the first frag. The second frag as well. Surely this is not doable from Carrigan. And he finally gets picked off from Kenny S. But my goodness, that was a lot closer than Envious were hoping for.
Dude, what a play that almost was there from the last guy from Carrigan there specifically. Holy crap. Did you see that? He pulls off one headshot, flips it around, gets the other one, and he almost gets that third one on a Kenny S too. So that was almost an amazing 4K to close on the map there from Carrigan. But thankfully, Kenny's able to shut that one down, and the retake dream, or the comeback dream, I should say, for Envious keeps itself alive for at least one more round here. But whew, that was amazing.
I can guarantee you I'd have lost my voice. I've already got a cold. If Carrigan pulled that off. So I'm like, thanks, Carrigan. Thanks, man. Had me in his heart. I appreciate it. Tech 9 Kevlar's though, and grenades picked up for XTSM.
So, and XTSM just gonna go right up to mid choke point now, not even screwing around with V, at least at the beginning of this round. Everybody's just gonna try to press right forward against this one. The resistance coming back in here now from Envy's. There's a good amount of nave coverage coming back in there, and Zipex actually is going to be able to pick up the first kill on a Kiyoshima. Now they press their way into this one. Kenny's actually stuck on balcony right now. He can't do anything about it. All the pressure shifted over towards Apex, but he's only gonna be able to find a one-for-one trade. Now Kenny again sitting up top. It'll be Happy that rotates in to pick up another kill. Kenny, he doesn't even realize he's a player sitting in a graveyard right now. He's trapped in pit looking for the op connection. There's so much confusion on both teams right now. They're all just looking around. They still don't fully realize Kenny's in pit, I don't think. It's down to a final two here. NBK moving in shuts down one, and Zipex is in graveyard there. He too is going to get taken down by Kenny, and Envy continue to hold on to their last little grasp of hope here as they continue that comeback. Now five more behind XTSM.
I gotta say though, I thought this round would definitely go to XTSM because in a 3-on-3 retake, there were two AWPs in play. When you're trying to retake a site like A, AWP's not always the best way forward. You know, maybe one AWP, but two maybe plays into the Tech-9s and the M4s that were picked up from XTSM, but it was MBK again through mid on quad, just a ridiculous retake. He lands himself a couple of headshots, turns the tides back in their favor. Now, Envious is starting to get close. There's still a bit of a gap, obviously, between the teams, but now there could be a bit of pressure mounting on the shoulders of XTSM, who are, like, desperate to just finish off this map. Dupree's taking some damage. Here come the AK-47s again, but Envious's CT side in this last few minutes has been pretty phenomenal, so let's see if XTSM can finally get it done.
So now moving themselves up towards middle here, going for the direct push, but Happy, close angle, could get some nice frags here on the way in towards it, but he's going to have to fall back very quickly. Missing that first connection, it's actually only going to bring him down to 8 HP, and he gets a headshot there on the way back at it. Now you're going to see here too, NBK tries to peek, and he too is taken down by Carrigan. They find those two entries, the rotations are on the way in towards the site right now, but Apex, he's got to press his way into this one. They do hold him up his back, but actually the plan comes in. Look at Apex! He actually can't pick up that second kill. Dupree, thankfully, finding the trade over on towards him. It's going to be these three from the T side trying to hold it off, but both Device and Dupree are extremely low. Most of the pressure to hold this one off is going to fall over to Zipex and the retake from Envious. Both are coming in from CT. One's already pushed in from construction. Kenny, sitting just on top of the bomb right now. He jumps in, locks onto that headshot there from Dupree. Zipex did find a kill. Device is stuck back in the corner over here at Emo. He's going to smoke himself to try and push back out against Kenny, but no, that's not going to happen. Kenny gets another close-up shot, but he's running out of time. He's got to stick this defuse. Zipex is not blinded by it at all. He's going to peek out. He's going to finish off Kenny, and finally, XTSM are going to finish off the map. map here with a final score of 16-10.
Valiant attempt, though, from Envious to try and hold on. And Kenny, by the way, in that retake, landed two sick shots there. Really nicely done, but unfortunately, the deficit was way too large to navigate through. And now I do worry a bit for Envious. You know, losing Inferno, a map that you'd have expected them to probably take. Now they're going through to Train, and that's where XTSM are pretty damn strong. So let's hope the Envious can bounce back in the best possible way here and take us to that third map of Mirage.
For Envious, T-side is probably going to be their biggest problem back on Train, but we can talk more about that in a moment, guys. We're going to go to a short break, and as soon as we return, map number two here between Envious and XTSM is coming up at the Starlitter Star Series Season 14, presented by iLeague.